Right, firstly, take your feet closer together. We're going to do something called the waiter's bow. Make sure your knees are comfortable. Just take your hands forwards. Imagine you're holding a tray. I want you to do, keeping your back nice and strong, just tilt forwards, pop your bottom into the air, and just feel that stretch through the hamstrings. And really, I'll show you on the side. Really push your bottom up and back, guys, without locking the knees. And then just tilt down until you can feel that stretch running through the back of your legs. Just stay there in that position, head in line with the spine. Really make sure you feel that stretch, really stick your bottom up and back. Take the legs a little bit wider. We're going to come into a deep squat now, stretching through the groin. What to do is take your hands together and just sit your bottom as low as you can, guys. A nice deep squat. If you can, take your hands on the floor and just roll your body weight from your toes to your heels. If you can't get this low, guys, then just stay as low as you can. You can sit your bottom all the way down. And then just rock your body weight forwards and back. Really great. This one develops really fast as well, guys. If you can't do this, keep on trying. And after a week or so, you'll be able to get down there. Okay, just sit here and balance. And then when you're ready, push into those feet. Push up. And slowly coming out. Great work, well done. Just shake it out. Next, we're going to stretch through the calf muscle. All you do is take a big step back and then push all your body weight into that back heel. Just bring knees a little bit soft. The back leg's nice and straight. Just hold it there. Now we're looking for a straight back. There should be a straight line from your shoulders, your head, all the way down to your heel. You can wiggle back your heel until you can really feel that stretch. Remember that front knee stays over the heel. With my soul. And slowly changing legs. Again, big step backwards. Hold in that position. Your legs, imagine they're on a mini railroad. So again, if they're underneath each other, behind each other, then you'll fall over, okay? So make sure you're legs are apart. This is why it's quite good to have a mat, and then you can physically see how far you are away. And again, think about that straight line. It's hard to stay in this position. You can put your hands on as long as you're not leaning forwards, okay? So keep that chest nice and proud. Legs. You can do a similar stretch. So I'm going to take the leg back, come on the tiptoes, drop the knee down, and then push the hips forwards. Okay, so big stretch on the hip flexor. To increase that stretch, take the arm up and over, pull the arm down. Whichever knee's down, you take the opposite arm up and over. Turn around so you can see what I'm doing. So other leg, big step back, drop that knee, push the hip forwards, take the arm up and over. Really great stretch through the hip flexor. Really look into that thigh, drop the knee lower if you need to. Take the foot behind, and then just re-